إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حتى أتاه اليقين فجزاه الله عنا خير ما جزى نبيا عن أمته ورسولا عن قومه ثم أما بعد عباد الله فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي رسول الله وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار عياذا بالله وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون أيها المؤمنون إن من أعظم نعم الله تعالى على هذه البشرية ومن أجل فضائله علينا أن أنزل إلينا هذا الدين العظيم وشرع لنا هذه الشريعة المحكمة المعجزة هذه الشريعة التي لا تدع صغيرة ولا كبيرة ولا تند عنها شاردة ولا واردة تهذب النفس وتقوم السلوك وتدير الحياة في نظام عجيب يتناول المرء من جميع جوانبه ويدير الحياة بكل أنشطتها في نظام معقد محكم لا يصدر إلا عن عليم خبير لا يصدر إلا عن إله عظيم لا يضعه إلا خالق قادر رحيم بالبشر عادل فيما بينهم فالحمد لله أولا وآخرا أن أنزل هذا الدين والحمد لله ظاهرا وباطنا أن عرفنا بهذا الدين والحمد لله في الأولى والآخرة أن هدانا لهذا الدين إن من خصائص هذا الدين أنه يعطي للإنسان شحنات روحانية فيقوي نفسه ويزكيها فإذا ما سعى الإنسان في هذه الأرض بمنهج الله ليقيم منهج الله وينفذ ما خلق من أجله من الاستخلاف الذي أمر به أبونا آدم عليه السلام فإذا ما فعل ذلك وجد من الطاقة الروحية ومن السمو النفسي ما يعينه على هذه المهمة العظيمة ثم إن الله تعالى وهو الرحيم العالم بنا الخبير بما نحتاج قد جعل لنا محطات في حياتنا نتزود بها وننهل منها ونقتدي بما نجده من الخير فيها واختار لنا أياما مخصوصة وأزمنة مخصوصة وأماكن فاضلة، فهو سبحانه يخلق ما يشاء ويختار. وإنا في هذه الأيام العظيمة ليس لنا من خيار إلا أن نتعرض لنفحات الله تعالى ورحماته، ليس لنا من طريق إلا طريق الله عز وجل الذي رسمه لنا واضحا جليا في هذه الأيام المباركة، وفتح لنا من الخير ما هو به عليم. وليس أمام المؤمن إلا أن ينهل كما أراد، وليس للعبد إلا أن يأخذ من الخير بحسب ما يستطيع. فهي أيام معدودات قليلات تنتهي وينتهي هذا الموسم العظيم، وينتظر الإنسان حتى يرد على الموسم القادم بفضل الله ورحمته. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. First, I would like to invite my brothers to move forward, inshallah, to fill the gaps in all sides. May Allah Azza wa Jal make space for you in Al-Jannah. Al-Jannah is going to be very crowded, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make space for the believers. The gates of Al-Jannah will be more crowded than this place, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make space for all the believers to pass through. So make space for your brothers, please. Make the effort to spot any gap in front of you and move forward. Jazakumullah ta'ala khayran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored us when He guided us to this deen. This deen, or this way of life that is designed by the Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the only way of success. Because all aspects of this deen, all of them, they do complement one another. And from these aspects you find the spiritual aspect and the ethical and the moral aspect. They build the personalities, so people or the believers or the worshippers and the slaves of Allah can work in this life according to what Allah Azza wa Jal created them for. We need energy, we need motivation. This is something that well known in every task. What about if this task is to look after this planet on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to succeed Allah azza wa jal in His authority on earth? This is the reason Allah created us for. Allah created Adam to be His successor on earth. What about if this is the task? How much energy we need, how much motivation we require. Allah Azza wa Jal is the only one who knows this. And because of that, Allah designed this deen, and part of this deen is to give us the spiritual motivation and the mental strength and the ethical power to be able to carry out the task of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this planet. And Allah Azza wa Jal selects certain times and certain places in which people can get these powers and those energies that are required. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who creates and the one who selects. And one of these times are these 10 days that have started yesterday, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. These 10 days are special days. They come possibly after the month of Ramadan, a couple of months or a bit more after the month of Ramadan. We get these 10 days to give us another charge. Another pack of energy that is going to drive us for the next few months to come. Why these 10 days? First, as I said, Allah is the one who creates and selects. But how do we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selects these days? That started yesterday, and they are going to end by the day of Eid. First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by them according to the majority of the Mufassireen. Majority of those who interpreted the Quran, they said when Allah said in Surah Al-Fajr, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ, Allah swears by these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran swears only by Himself, His names and attributes, and the greatest of His creatures. Second, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions them in Surah Al-Hajj by saying, وَيَذْكُرُ اسْمَ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ, and they glorify or they mention the name of their Lord on known days. These are the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam specified these days by saying that the most beloved actions, or Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said it exactly in this way. He said, Allah does not like good deeds on any days more than the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Except, then Rasul ﷺ made exception. He said, except someone, إِلَّا رَجُلٌ خَاطَرَ بِنَفْسِهِ وَمَالِهِ فَلَمْ يَرْجِعْ مِنْ ذَلِكَ بِشَيْءٍ. Except someone who risked himself and his wealth. Someone went on the path of Allah with his wealth and he went back with nothing. Meaning that this man sacrificed himself, got murdered or martyred, and he sacrificed his wealth on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning that the good deeds on these 10 days are more rewardful than any action. Except someone who went out on the path of Allah and he was killed and his wealth was gone on the path of Allah. Also on these days we have the day of Arafah. And we'll speak about that inshallah in a few minutes. Also on these days we have the day of An-Nahr, the day of sacrifice, which is according to many scholars the best day of the year. And this is according to a hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he said the best day in the year is the day of An-Nahr. Also, according to Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, one of the greatest scholars who explained Sahih al-Bukhari, he said, in these 10 days, يَجْدَمِعُ فِيهَا أُمَّهَاتُ الْعِبَادَاتِ. He said that the main acts of worship, they are gathered on these 10 days. So you'll have a salam, you have a siyam, you have a sadaqah, you have a dhikr, and you have the sacrifice, al-udhiyah, and you have al-hajj. And there are no other days in the year when you have all these acts come together. If you manage to do all of them in other days, but you cannot do Hajj except in these days. Ummahatul Ibadat, the main acts of worship, they're all gathered together in these 10 days that end by Al-Hajj. What do we do in these days? Now we go to the practical side of this reminder. What do we need to do in these days that have started yesterday? First, my brothers and sisters, we need to repent. At-tawbah ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yaqulu Allah azza wa jal, wa tubu ila Allah jami'an ayyuhal mu'minun la'allakum tuflihun. In Surah An-Nur. And one very important reminder when we come to the issue of at-tawbah is the issue of raddul mazalim, to pay people their rights. If you wronged someone, if you took someone's property, make sure that you return that back. If you have any dealing with a riba, make sure you clear your wealth and your house from this. Raddul mazalim. Don't be the bankrupt person that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about. When he said to his companions, أَتَدْرُونَ مَنِ الْمُفْلِسِ, do you know who is the bankrupt? They said, the one who has no money. He said, no. He said, the real bankruptcy is the one who comes يوم القيامة بحسنات, a lot of good deeds. In a narration he said, أَمْثَالَ جِبَالِ تِهَامَ, like mountains and mountains of good deeds, fasting and Hajj and charity and sacrifice and recitation of Quran and night prayers, huge amounts of reward, mountains of good deeds. ثُمَّ يَأْتِي, and then he comes before Allah, وَقَدْ شَتَمَ هَذَا وَأَكَلَ مَالَ هَذَا وَاغْتَابَ هَذَا, and he mentioned a few acts. He said, he comes in front of Allah while he insulted this one and took the property of that one and wronged that one and hit the other and did such and such to other people. They will come one after the other to take their rights back. Yawm al-Qiyamah, there is no money. You can't issue checks. You can't transfer money to anyone. Yawm al-Qiyamah, the currency will be good deeds. Then the first one will take the right in good deeds. Allahu A'lam, how Allah is going to quantify that. So the first one will take some, and the second will take, and the third, and the fourth, and the mountains coming down and down. Just visualize it. A queue of people are here to take the rights back, and your mountain of good deeds is coming down a bit by bit, until there is no mountain anymore. فَإِذَا فَنِيَتْ حَسَنَاتُ, until they take everything, all good deeds vanish. The person becomes bankrupt. But there are still people in the queue. فَإِذَا فَنِيَتْ حَسَنَاتُهُ أُخِذَ مِنْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ فَطُرِحَتْ عَلَيْهِ, their bad deeds, their sins, that will be taken off them, of their shoulders, and we will be placed on him, فَيُلْقَى فِي النَّارِ, and he will be chucked in the fire. May Allah protect us. Amen. We can work very well in this dunya, neglecting this issue, and there will come the Yawm al-Qiyamah, and everything will go to waste. So while we are in these 10 days, we are very enthusiastic to raise and to improve our iman and get closer to Allah Azza wa Jal and gain a lot of hasanat and reward. Be mindful of this. Don't become one of those who will be bankrupt Yawm al-Qiyamah. The second good deed to do in these 10 days, of course, is Al-Hajj. If you are lucky enough to be chosen to visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this year and perform Hajj, this is the main act of worship in these 10 days. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Umratu ila al-Umra kaffaratun lima baynahuma, that one Umrah to the next expiate whatever between them, والحج المبرور ليس له جزاء إلا الجنة, and the accepted Hajj has no reward except الجنة. Allah says in the Quran, فمن فرض فيهن الحج فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج. The one who intends to perform Hajj, there is no sin, there is no vain talk, there is no argument in الحج. The acts of worship that we try to do these days, all of them without exception, have moral dimensions. All of them must lead to better people
and better personalities must lead to high standard moralities. The other act of worship that we need to remember in these days is fasting, as-siyam. And we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in al-hadith al-Qudsi, كُلُّ عَمَلِ ابْنِ آدَمَ لَهُ إِلَّا الصَّوْمِ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. All the deeds of the son of Adam are for him. Meaning that you do something and you know what's the reward for this. Except as-sawm. It is for me and I reward for it. إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. And one of the meanings of this ayah that those who fast, they will be given their reward without measure. There is no account. You can't say the reward of the fasting is 10 or 20 or 100, 1 million. It's something that is unimaginable and something cannot be counted. And again, as-siyam is to improve our personalities. As-siyam is to make us in control of our desires, in control of our emotions, in control of our reactions, in control of our behavior. Not our desires, not our shaitan, not our lusts become in control of us. As-siyam trains us to take the lead and to control ourselves on our path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another act of worship during these 10 days is as-salah. As-salah, of course, is amud al-deen, is the main pillar of al-deen. But while we are in these 10 days, we need to remember to improve our salah. Have a step forward more than just doing the acts of standing and going down. One of them is the hadith that was narrated by Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu. أحب الأعمال إلى الله الصلاة على وقتها. Rated by البخاري and Muslim. البخاري and Muslim رضي الله تعالى عنهما narrated this very authentic hadith that was reported by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله تعالى عنه that the most beloved deed to Allah is الصلاة on time. And الصلاة on time, as explained by Ibn Hajar and al-Imam al-Nawawi and others, they said the prayer ala waqtiha, meaning at the beginning of the time. When you hear the adhan, you rush to as-salah. You stop everything and begin your uninterrupted meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on time. We try to keep everything in this life on time, and we need to keep our salah on time too. This is the most important 5 daily meetings with our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. The most beloved deeds to Allah. In the 10 days where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the good deeds the most. So the most beloved inside the most beloved time. Most beloved act. In the most beloved time, as-salatu ala waqtiha, in these 10 days. And also, from the improvement of our salah, is to make sure that the salah is done in jama'ah. Our deen, my brothers and sisters, is the deen of al-jama'ah. And one symbol of that is al-hajj itself. Allah Azza wa Jal selects the time and the place. And the way you do it, you can't just go and do hajj at other times. It must be at that time, in that place. Because this deen is the deen of al-jama'ah. Same as as-salah. As-salah is to be performed in jama'ah. And same as any other act of life to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to be done in jama'ah. As-salah teaches us to have leadership, to follow the leaders. No one can move in salah before the imam. No one can go for ruku' before the imam. And no one can take longer than the imam. No one can say I am more pious and I want to spend more time in sujood. It's just the following of the leadership that is appointed by Allah Azza wa Jal. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا جُعِلَ الْإِمَامُ لِيُؤْتَمَّ بِهِ. An imam is appointed to be followed. So as-salah in jama'ah teaches us this. No one can learn this unless they pray their prayers in jama'ah. Make sure that your five daily prayers, the five, not four of them, the five daily prayers are done in jama'ah. Whether that in the masjid, and this is the priority, or at home, or at work, or anywhere. Alhamdulillah, we live now somewhere when you'll find Muslims around you anywhere. And if this is not the case, make sure this is the case. If you're not surrounded by people who say La ilaha illallah throughout the day, you are in the wrong place, my friend. You must be surrounded with the believers all over the day. Every time is the time for salah. You must find a believer near you to perform salah at least with one believer. And this is the jama'ah is done. It's achieved when you perform the salah with one more person. Two people, you'll get the reward of the jama'ah, subhanallah. Don't miss out in the many benefits from the salah of the jama'ah. And one of them is the salah of jama'ah is counted 27 times of the reward of the salah individually. And of course, add to that the salatul nawafil, the sunan, and other than the five daily obligatory prayers. And I'll go quickly to the next few good deeds to do during these days. At-takbir, wa-tahmid, wa-tahleel, to say Allahu Akbar, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, at any time during these days. But then we'll have specific times from the Fajr of the day of Arafah to say it after every Salah for the day of Arafah and the day of Eid, and 3 days after that to say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Or there are other ways to say that. And this is after every Salah since the Fajr of the day of Arafah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. Also from the good deeds of these 10 days, Al-Udhiyah, the sacrifice, which is according to many scholars is wajib, is an obligation upon everyone who can. Anyone who can sacrifice at least a sheep for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Eid, it becomes compulsory on them. And it's sufficient to sacrifice one sheep for the entire family. It's not for every person, like Zakat al-Fitr. This is one sheep for the entire family, or 7 families can share in one cow or one camel. But the ritual here is to slaughter the animal, to spill the blood of the animal for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is different from any other charity. This udhiyah has certain rituals to be done. The animal has to be sacrificed in a certain way, and the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to be done, and it has to be done at a specific time as well. And I said some scholars, or many scholars, said it's compulsory. Others said it is sunnah mu'akkada. It is a recommended sunnah, or highly recommended sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So make sure, if you haven't made your arrangement for that, make sure you make it. So on the day of Eid or the following 3 days, your animal is sacrificed for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And lastly, my brothers and sisters, remember the most important act of worship and the essence of worship, as the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, is ad-du'a. It's to raise your hands and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for khayra yad-dunya wal-akhirah, for the good of this life and the next. All things that I mentioned today, raise your hands and ask Allah to make you able to do them. Ask Allah to give you the strength to fast, to perform hajj, to do the dua. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you the strength to do the takbir and the tahleel, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these days. We need to raise our hands in this good time when you come, maybe between Adhan and Iqamah, before you break your fast, when you're fasting on the day of Arafah, it is our chance. The fasting on the day of Arafah expiates the sins of the previous and the coming year. Don't miss out. And then when you come at the end of the day of Arafah, raise your hands throughout the day, but specifically before the Maghrib on that day, raise your hands and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to ease the life of our brothers and sisters in the rest of the world. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today on the day of Al-Jumu'ah, from this place, from the house of Allah Azza wa Jal, on the second day of the days of Dhul Hijjah, to be merciful with the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to ease the affairs of our brothers and sisters who are struggling in different parts of the world, whether that in Bangladesh, or that in Pakistan or Afghanistan, or that is in other countries in Palestine and in Iraq and in Syria and in Egypt and other countries where the Muslims are persecuted or they're struggling with their livelihood. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك ومن النار اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك ومن النار اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك ومن النار اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها زكها أنت خير من زكاها إنك وليها ومولاها اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وبفضلك عمن سواك اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه واجعلنا من الراشدين اللهم ارحم أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم فك أسر مأسوريهم وضمد جراح مجروحيهم واشف مرضاهم واكفل أيتامهم وأراملهم ومساكينهم وكن معهم وكن لهم عونا ومؤيدا ونصيرا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وأقم الصلاة.